Ross, it is nice to see you. How are you doing?
Very good, man. Thank you.
Oh, wonderful. And how is our girl? Well, your girl.
She's doing very well.
Oh, how would you describe your relationship with her now?
Kind of like a glove. Just fit.
Oh, like a glove. That's perfect. Oh, Camden, how are you doing? I guess she's a woman of few words. Oh,
yeah.
You said your relationship is like a glove. I have to ask you, you're coming up on, it'll be 1 year in September that the two of you have been together.
That is correct. Yes, ma'am.
Does it feel like a year?
Yes and no. COVID's been a little strange. Think time flies by, but in general, it's in some moments you feel that things have gone utterly slow, and then other times you can't even believe, you almost feel like it's been 5 years rather than a year.
COVID time. I think that's the perfect way, right? It's COVID time. Well, since you brought up COVID and quarantine and the pandemic, let me ask you how that stress has contributed and is playing a part in your own emotional journey, the stress of the quarantine, the stress of the pandemic.
For me, I'm very lucky, man, blessed, lucky. I have a very supportive wife. I have two lovely kids. I've got an unbelievable network of friends. The doctors that I'm extremely close with really look after me. So in those regards, I feel like I'm looked after. But there is sometimes just an utter stress of, you know, you're trying to do go to the VA to get an appointment and you can't because they're shut down, and you're wondering how you get your medicine filled, and there's that, or works, you're not able to go to work properly and you don't know what's going on. There's all this chaos. But I think that's to everybody. So I don't think it's as far as stress, I think I'm lucky. I think other people are much more in tougher situations.
Well, I hear you on that. Let me ask you, can you imagine going through this stressful experience without Camden?
The short answer is yes, you can imagine it, but the reality is you realize how much she's there for me. Hmm. And it's not just the fact that she helps pick things up, or it's, to be honest with you, it's, she just helps me. Hmm. I really just, like, if I feel tense or like down or anything like that, you look at these beautiful eyes and it's a kind of uplifting atmosphere, you know, aspect of kind of I guess energizes me, makes me reevaluate things and centers me.
Centers you. And I would imagine it's very affirming, correct, to look at her eyes and to know that you have this special bond with her. Can we see her beautiful eyes that make you feel, so there she is, there she is. Those are those eyes that make you feel good and made so many people feel good as the viewers shared her journey over the year and get to see the two of you together. It's wonderful. It fills us all up to see it.
Yes, ma'am.
I want to ask you, what have you learned about her? Is there any particular quirk that one day you said, wow, she does that, I never would have imagined it? Is there a particular Camden quirk that you'd like to share with us?
I always thought that those things were supposed to remain secret. I think, you know, I was asked about her snoring. And she definitely snores extremely loud. She will dream. I've had people that have come to my desk in my cubicle and talk to me, and they've heard her kind of in a dream, and they suddenly, they don't even know I have a dog. She's so quiet. And then all of a sudden she starts like barking, or I don't know, she's dreaming about something, maybe bones and chasing
squirrels.
She gets excited, and they suddenly look at me like all eyed, like I'm hiding something behind my desk. And they're like, "You have a dog there? I didn't even know." I'm like, "Yeah, she's asleep."
Ross, how often do people recognize the two of you?
Honestly, nobody recognizes me. Everybody recognizes Camden. A lot of people stop me or they say, "Is that the WBAL dog, or is that the Today dog, or the Purpose, puppy with a Purpose dog?" And you know, it's an honor to have her. And I've always been extremely grateful and thankful for American Vet Dogs, and you all, WBAL, and people of Baltimore, and your viewers for voting for her name and everything.
Well, it's so wonderful to see the two of you together. Before I let you go, how is your whole family doing? You have two children. How is your wife doing? How has everyone taken to Camden?
Again, we are extremely lucky or blessed. We just, it's a tough time out there for everybody, and we are doing really well. So we're extremely grateful for that. You know, little one's just turned three at his birthday. Besides some Paw Patrol stuff, you know, we're also in the terrible threes where
oh, yeah,
your plates go down onto the floor.
Yes. Those terrible threes, they do a real number on the terrible twos, don't they?
Yes. Yes, they do.
Well, we appreciate you joining us. It was so nice to see the two of you. We wish you continued good health, particularly as we all navigate this together, and we hope you come visit with us again.
Well, thank you. And again, thank you so much for the support for American Vet Dogs. I mean, I always said it, I've been extremely grateful for, you know, the certain doctors at Walter Reed that have, like Dr. Boucher, referred me, and WBAL, and the NBC for doing the Puppies with a Purpose, American Vet Dogs, and your viewers. It's such a wonderful program. I don't think people realize, but I've talked to more veterans who have had dogs and the impact that the dogs have had on their lives. I mean, I've literally talked to people who are telling me, in fact, I was at an event and a guy said, "I was on the brink of, you know, the end." And I was taking all these pills every day, and I was just wondering why I don't get it. And then I got my dog, and my life changed. And that's what these dogs do. And I don't think people really understand what they do for some of the first responders and the service members out there. It's not just, like I've said before, it's not a piece of equipment like a cane or a wheelchair. They give us just a positivity that nobody else can.
Well, before you go, can you give Camden right now a hug from all of us here at WBAL? We all fell in love with her. Just one good hug for Camden from all of us. Oh, perfect. Thank you, Ross.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.